One of the things I like about the free version of Bitdefender is that it has a free online threat prevention feature. It can save you from threats being downloaded on your computer. It can save you from phishing sites. It also scans email for threats. So it's obviously a wonderful security feature. But the problem is, we don't really know if it is good enough for all those threats. And for that, I have a plan. It's up to date. Today I have some interesting URLs. I have URLs that are used by cyber criminals for spreading malwares. As you can see, some of these are used for spreading the infamous Mozi botnet. I also have some URLs of compromised websites. A lot of times, threat actors take control of the website of a genuine business and then plant malware or add phishing pages to it. Anyway, I think we have had enough chit-chat, so let's get down to business. As usual, I will use an automation tool to open all the links. So, let's get started. I have already disabled Microsoft Defender's Smart Screen so that it does not conflict with Bitdefender's web protection. Automation tool is saying that the second one is missed, but I can see Bitdefender actually detected it. Looks like we have our first download. txt file just changed to htm, not sure what's going on. We have couple more download attempts, but they are not getting downloaded. Not sure if it's really a network issue or Bitdefender blocking the attempts. Threads with same name but from different websites are trying to get downloaded, but with no success. Another thread with the same name, but this time it successfully evaded Bitdefender's security. And another one went through the security. Interestingly, Bitdefender is blocking the web page, but not the download. Alright, that test has finished. I don't really want to rely on the result given by the automation tool. So let's just count the downloads. We can see 9 download attempts, only 5 were successful. I don't know if any of you guys noticed this, but the threads with the same name were from Indian websites. And I don't think that the website owners are hosting this malware. I think these sites were compromised and the threat actors has planted this malware there. Let's try to open this one. It requires a password. The last time I was doing this test, Bitdefender were not blocking the page of this malware, and there were password in the page. But this time, Bitdefender blocked the page, so no password. Let's see if VirusTotal has something to say about these files. Okay, looks like it's clean. Oops, that's actually the page Bitdefender was showing us on the blocked website. Not sure how this ended up in here. Let's check the zipped file. Well, looks like this file is quite new. Only Kaspersky has detected it as a threat. To be fair, I'm slightly worried, because I've been doing this particular test for last 2 days, and seems like the compromised websites are still compromised. The authority of those websites are not doing anything about it, so a lot of people, a lot of students are going to be in trouble, as some of these are educational websites. Anyway, that's it for today. Subscribe and leave a thumbs up. And also don't forget to stay safe. Have a good day.